there was a man like you and me, as simple as a man could ever be. And he was happy as a king, except for one peculiar thing. He had a clock that worked all right. It worked all right, but not exactly quite. Instead of going tick-tock-tick, the crazy clock went tock-tick-tock. The poor old man just raved and raved, because nobody could say why his silly clock behaved that hickory-dickory way. But now a famous man is he. He owns a public curiosity. From far and wide the people flock to hear the syncopated clock.
The history of clocks, well, it dates back more than 5,000 years. And while we've come a long way since the sundials, antique clocks are still collector's items, and they could be worth a lot of money. And that's according to our first guest. It's Jim Reese. He's the president of the Colusa chapter of the National Association of Watch and Clock Collectors. Welcome.
Thank you.
You brought some beautiful pieces in.
Yeah, I love clocks, and it's a pleasure to have them here so we can show them to other people.
We're going to talk about this one, but first, you guys have a wonderful event that's coming up that people, if they have a clock, maybe it was their grandfather's, maybe it was an old timepiece, yep, they can come out and see you, and you can give them an assessment on what they're holding.
Yeah, we sure can. And the clocks that you see here will be in that show, by the way, along with many others, and watches. We'll have a lot of watches there, different kinds of watches. We have two major objects that we're going to accomplish then. One is looking at clocks or watches and explaining to people whether they can be repaired or should be repaired, and what some sources are, and then give them an estimate of the value of the clock. And most people have them, but have no idea what they really have in their hands.
You know, when you think of the Antiques Roadshow, such a popular show, and that's the way this is going to be. People can come out and, for instance, what's this one about? What's the story? It's beautiful.
Well, this is an antique French clock. It's from the late 1700s, early 1800s. It's an example of prior to being produced, prior to the Industrial Revolution, done by one piece at a time, one clock at a time, and the clocks were quite expensive as a result of that. The trick was to get clocks to the people, and only the rich could afford these.
Okay, yeah, and you can tell, I mean, you can tell a master touched this. And I guess you would wind it?
Well, that's right, all okay. Key wind. All of these are key wind.
Okay, now what about this piece?
Ah, now...
beautiful wood.
Oh, it is gorgeous, and it's an indication. The Industrial Revolution got clock use in this country off to a great start. Mm-hmm. Here is a fine example. Put it on a mantle, it looks great, but it also tells time, and people at that time had to get up to get to work, and the clock, of course, was just the perfect thing
for
them.
What was the date again on this one?
That one's about 1865.
Okay, 1865. Now, you brought so many pieces. What's the next one you'd like to show us?
Well, the next one I'd like to show is right in front of us
here. The one in the center.
That particular clock was wildly popular back in the 1880s. And the first person who put it out was out to make money, obviously, because of the quality of the clock.
I want to turn this around so you can see the detail.
It caught on so well that many other people also began to make, there was great competition in those days, also began to make that style of clock, in quietly a little different looking this way or that. It lasted and was quite popular for almost 40 years before people decided they'd had all they wanted of it and wanted other clocks to be produced.
And what about this piece?
Now, here's an example. It's a mission clock.
Can I pick it up?
Or you
certainly can.
I'm nervous.
How old is this piece?
All right. This mission clock.
Thanks.
This mission clock dates from 1910 to 1930.
Okay.
And mission furniture became wildly popular, and clock manufacturers were sensitive to that sort of thing and made clocks that were useful to people who liked mission material. And this is a perfect example of that sort of thing.
And these are all going to be on at your show, which is the Antique Clock and Watch Show, Saturday, February 2nd, and that's from 10 to 2 p.m., and it's at the Lee County Public Library, and that's in Fort Myers. We have the number, it's 574-3653. This is open to the public.
Yes, and that library, by the way, is on Gladiolus in South Fort Myers, and you can find it at Gladiolus and Bass Road. We will be doing evaluations of the clocks, and we will also be giving a lot of good advice, but we also are going to have a drawing for three door prizes, and all of them are horological items, or clocks that people could use. So it's a good way to come up with a clock
and
while
meet
you're
the
having
experts.
A good time.
Everyone who is involved in this process have a passion for timepieces, experts, watches, wrist watches, pocket watches, and we're going to be talking about that a little bit later in the show. But more importantly, everybody can come out, they can go around to the different areas, they can find out about this if they're interested in it, and if they have some old pieces, they can bring them in and you can assess what they're valued, the dates, and I think that'll be a great, great thing for them to do.
I think it's an opportunity for us to do something for the community and for the community to get benefit.
Oh, I think a lot of people are going to be joining you, Jim.
Thank you.
I'm sure of it.
We look forward to them.
If you want more information on how you can attend this antique show, you're going to be